I will not put my feet on the floor in the morning until I talk to God. Can you say without hesitation that God is first in your life? It's silly to say that we don't have time for God. And if we don't have time for Him, then He's not first in our lives. Do you think about God and His goodness in your life? Do you take time to thank God for your blessings, even little ones? Live to please the Lord. Make decisions that are pleasing to God. How many times do we decide to put God first, but then the keeping Him first becomes an issue because, in case you haven't noticed, the world is full of things to distract us. I'm sure you've experienced, you make a decision that you're going to pray every morning and study the Word before you do anything else, and man, all of a sudden it's nighttime and you don't even know what happened, but that plan you made didn't work out. And so, more than anything, and I want you to listen to me, more than anything, the devil will fight you about keeping God first in your time, in your finances, and in many, many, many different ways. You see, here's the thing that you don't want to do. I found myself many years ago trying so hard to work God into my schedule. And finally one day the Lord said, why don't you just work your schedule around me? So are you trying to find a place to put God into your schedule? Or would you be willing today to say, God, from now on you're going to be first, and I don't care what else has to go or what I have to change, what I have to make an adjustment in, I want to keep you first in my life in everything. Let me tell you, being a Christian just does not work out right if God is a sideline in your life. He doesn't want to just be part of your Sunday morning. He wants to be welcomed into and be a vital part of everything that you do. Millions of people believe in Jesus and go to church on Sunday, but God is not first in their life. He puts you first in His life. Do you know that? Every single one of you is first in God's thoughts. And I want you to understand this today. You are on God's mind all the time. He's always thinking about you. We could not even count the thoughts that God has toward us. They would be like little grains of sand on the beach. Before you ever arrived on planet Earth, God made a plan for every single day of your life. He won't force you to walk in it, but He would like you to walk in it. He would like to guide you and lead you through life, and literally, let me say it again, be involved in everything you do. In every decision you make, God wants to be part of it. That's what Jesus died for us to have. Boy, we sure need God when we're desperate. Well, you know, we can't just go to God when we're desperate. That's not a walk with God. You say, you mean to tell me that I need to spend time with God every day? How about like about every 5 minutes? God is not for the emergencies in our life. He is our life. Well, so we can just keep trying to do a bunch of stuff without Him and just fail time after time, and hopefully we'll finally get it. That's what happened to me. Now, some of you are still young enough that you think, oh man, I gotta get married, I gotta have kids, I gotta climb the ladder of success, you know. Well, that's good. Do all that. But if you do all that without God, you'll come to the end of it and you'll still be very dissatisfied. You're gonna be like a person roaming around in the wilderness, seeing one mirage after another that you think has got the water that you need. Well, this will make me happy. Well, this will make me happy. Well, this will make me happy. Nothing is going to make you happy, content, and satisfied. You may go and enjoy a vacation, and you're happy while you're there, but who wants to just enjoy certain events and days in their life? I want to enjoy every single ordinary day of my life, every day.